Hey Mia, how are you? Oh no, I'm so sorry to hear you're not feeling well, but wait, you're a robot, so germs don't affect you. How did you get sick, Mia? Oh yeah, you really gotta watch out for malware, huh? I bet you'll be careful next time, though. Oh, computers and robots can get sick, just like people can. Your computer can catch these cyber diseases known as malware just from connecting to a Wi-Fi network or clicking a misleading link. It's almost impossible to keep your computer from being infected unless you know what to watch out for. In this lesson, salute, Mia. In this lesson, you'll learn how dangerous viruses and other malware can be, and how to avoid these digital diseases to keep your computer happy and healthy. Let's gesundheit. Let's get into it. Bad programs on your computer are known as malware, a word that combines malicious with software. The purpose of most malware is the same: to make money for its creator. But each malware program reaches that goal through different methods. Ransomware takes your files or even your entire computer hostage, demanding that you pay a ransom, meaning money, if you want your computer back to normal. Oftentimes, ransomware will act like your computer has been locked by a police agency or even the FBI to scare you. But remember, if the authorities had reason to freeze your computer, they wouldn't just charge you money to unfreeze it. The FBI doesn't work that way. That's just ransomware. Some malware developers go for a more subtle method of making money. They infect your computer with spyware, which secretly watches what you do and gathers information about you, what websites you visit, your passwords to those sites, payment details you type in. Yikes! Then that information is sold, often to other hackers. The hackers get all the necessary details to sneak into your accounts and steal your money, and the spy gets a nice chunk of money as well. Malware can even come in the form of a rootkit, which gives its creator remote access to your computer. They can install new programs, record you while you use your computer, and even make changes to the operating system itself. And you may never realize somebody else is messing with your computer. This allows them to install other forms of malware and disguise the infection for a long time while making money from that malware the whole time. To understand how to protect yourself from malware, you first have to understand how your computer gets infected by it. The most well-known type of malware is the virus. Viruses attach themselves to computer files, similar to how biological viruses attach to cells in your body. Once you open an infected file, the virus is activated. Then the virus starts replicating, attaching itself to all the files in your computer in the hopes that you'll share those files with somebody else and infect their computer too. Sharing infected files with somebody else is like having your computer sneeze directly onto theirs. Ew. Ugh. But even if you never receive a single file from anybody else, your computer can still get infected with malware because viruses aren't the only type. A worm is a malware that spreads completely on its own. Unlike a virus, a worm doesn't have to attach itself to a file and hope that you'll share it with others. Once your computer has a worm, that worm will continue replicating itself all on its own. This wouldn't be so dangerous if the worms just replicated on an already infected computer. The problem is, worms will also spread across any connection to other computers on the same network. Once worms are in a system or network, it's almost impossible to clear them out. If you've ever wondered why businesses often have a separate Wi-Fi just for guests, this is why. The last thing they need is for a guest with a worm-infected phone to join the same network as the devices that are used for important business matters. And then there's Trojan horses. Trojan horses are named for the giant wooden horse that the Greek army hid inside to trick the Trojans. Once inside the city of Troy, the Greek army popped out of the horse. Well, did what armies do in the cities of their enemies. You get it. Trojan horse malware uses the same method to infect your computer, although it's usually just called a Trojan, because it's a little weird to imagine a horse inside your computer. Trojans are disguised as something else on the internet, a computer game, an ebook, anything that will entice people to download the file. Once the file is downloaded, the Trojan is activated, installing malware on your system without you even realizing it, and waging war on your computer! With what you now know about malware, can you think of any steps you could take to keep your computer malware-free? Pause the video now and jot down your ideas. Let's find out how many of your anti-malware tips match mine. First of all, keep your computer updated. Cybercriminals constantly come up with new tricks to get around your computer's security features, and then operating systems get updated to shut down those new hacking tricks. It's a constant cycle. Keeping your computer updated limits the ways malware can infect your computer, at least until it finds a new hole in the defenses. Next, it's a good idea to install additional antivirus software on your computer. Antivirus software allows you to scan your computer for any malware, not just viruses, and remove anything it finds. Some antivirus software will even scan links and files to let you know if they're infected before you even click on them. That brings us to our next tip, which you probably already guessed a few minutes ago. Don't click on suspicious links. Some links on the internet sound too good to be true. Free books here! Free movies here! Come to this website and we'll give you $1 million! Think of these links like you would a stranger offering you candy. It could be real or it could be a trap that risks your safety. Just like in a stranger danger situation, it's better to be safe than sorry, right? Finally, avoid clicking on ads or pop-ups no matter what they say. Cybercriminals know that you're being careful about malware, so they'll try to play into those fears with ads like these, claiming that your computer is already infected and the only way to cure the infection is by clicking this link and downloading this totally legit antivirus program. It seems obvious to us here right now that the download is actually going to be malware. After all, how would they already know your computer was infected before you downloaded their software? But in the moment, when you see this ad pop up, you might be too scared for your computer's safety to think straight. That's why I'm letting you know now. These ads are never real. Only trust messages from the antivirus software that's already installed on your computer. As long as you follow these tips, you should be totally safe from malware of all forms. For now. But it's also important to remember that malware developers get sneakier every day, so don't treat this list of tips as complete. You'll probably need to update your tactics as malware evolves in new ways to try to infect your computer. Malware isn't the only threat on the web. People around the world have billions of dollars stolen from them every year due to online scams. In our next lesson, you'll learn about the kind of scams to watch out for so you can avoid becoming part of an unfortunate statistic. Until then, remember, your brain is the smartest computer you'll ever have, so keep it charged and never stop updating it. See you next time! Hey, hey.